Each year, boaters are sickened or killed by entirely preventable poisoning from a gas you can't see, smell, or taste. Carbon monoxide is produced when carbon-based fuels, like gasoline or propane, are burned.
The most obvious source on a powerboat is the engine, and most incidents occur from exhaust leaking into enclosed areas, the rear deck near the swim platform, or directly behind a slow-moving boat.
It can also come from onboard generators, space and water heaters, stoves, and grills. It's important to know the symptoms of exposure to this deadly gas, what to do if you suspect someone has been exposed, and how to prevent it.
Carbon monoxide enters the bloodstream through the lungs, displacing needed oxygen and initially causing eye irritation, headache, nausea, confusion, weakness, and dizziness. Early symptoms mimic seasickness or intoxication.
Prolonged exposure to low concentrations or short exposure to high concentrations can lead to seizures, brain damage, unconsciousness, and death. Physical exertion accelerates the rate of poisoning.
If you or a fellow boater experiences any of its symptoms, seek fresh air immediately, ventilate the area, and shut off suspected sources of carbon monoxide.
Once out in the open air, administer oxygen if available. Contact medical help, and if the victim is not breathing, confirm there is a pulse and perform CPR until help arrives. It may be necessary to undergo emergency treatment at the closest medical facility.
By taking steps to detect and treat carbon monoxide poisoning early, you can help save your life or the lives of your passengers.
Carbon monoxide emissions create death zones for swimmers near or under the back deck or swim platform, and for everyone near exhaust vent areas.
Traveling at slow speeds can cause carbon monoxide to build up in the cabin, bridge, cockpit, aft deck, and open areas, and is exacerbated by a tailwind.
Operating at a high bow angle, overloading or improperly loading a boat can cause a backdraft drawing in exhaust fumes.
Docking, anchoring, or rafting in close proximity to other boats that have engines or generators running can also expose boat operators and their passengers to poisonous fumes.
To prevent carbon monoxide poisoning, maintain fresh air circulation throughout the boat and keep the engine tuned for peak performance. Know how and where carbon monoxide may accumulate.
Install marine-grade carbon monoxide detectors inside your boat. Test them regularly and believe them.
Never sit, teak surf, or hang on the back deck or swim platform while engines are running. Make sure ski ropes are an appropriate length. Always wear a life jacket. If someone passes out and falls overboard, this could save their life.
Before getting underway, ensure all exhaust system components are secure and free of rust, black streaking, water leaks, and corrosion. Inspect rubber exhaust hoses for burns, cracks, or deterioration, and replace as needed. Check that engines, generators, and cooling systems are properly tuned and well-maintained.
Educate family and friends about carbon monoxide so they are aware of the signs of early poisoning. Keep forward-facing hatches open, even in inclement weather, to allow fresh air in living spaces. When possible, run the boat so that prevailing winds help dissipate exhaust.
Carbon monoxide is one of the most dangerous threats on the water because boaters don't realize it's present until it's too late. Its most common source is a running engine. Carbon monoxide can make you sick in seconds, and high concentrations can kill. Symptoms can be confused with seasickness or intoxication. Avoid closed-off, poorly ventilated areas, and never ride or hang on a swim platform when the engine is running.
If carbon monoxide is suspected, open all windows, hatches, and ports to ventilate. Move a person to fresh air if carbon monoxide poisoning is indicated, and seek medical attention at once.